Hello everyone. So I hope you all are fine. So today, fourth class children, I'll complete the English grammar lesson which we had started in the previous class, lesson number 5. And the lesson was regarding articles. So the name of the lesson was articles. Do you remember, children? So today, on page number 37 in your Grammarite books, there is a passage. They have given a passage. See, children. Some articles are missing in this paragraph. In your notebook, rewrite the paragraph filling in the missing articles. Underline the articles that you insert. So here they have given a passage here. Right, children? So in this passage, they have used the articles incorrectly. So what you have to do? You have to write this passage again in your English notebook, but using the correct articles in that place. And you have to underline that article which you have used there. Right, children? Did you understand? So, I will post the pics in the group when I post the link for this lesson. Okay? So, moving on to the next topic. Turn your page. Turn page to 38. Comprehension. Read the passage and answer the questions that follow. So, here they have given a comprehension. And regarding that comprehension, they have given some questions we have to answer. So first, let us read this comprehension. Rohit completed his homework on time as he had promised. He asked his mother if he could go to buy an ice cream candy from Candy Cam, a store near their house. Mother said, "Here, take this money, buy yourself an ice candy, but make sure that the bar is wrapped properly or else it may make you ill." Rohit cycled to the store and asked the shopkeeper for an ice candy bar. "Do you want an orange or a strawberry bar?" asked the shopkeeper. Rohit thought for a bit and replied, "The orange bar." So this passage is about a boy named Rohit. So one day, what he did, he had to complete his homework. So he promised his mother that if he completes his homework, he will complete his homework in time. So he completed his homework, so his mother was very happy. So what happened? He asked his mother money for buying an ice candy bar. Okay, so that shop, that ice candy bar shop was near their house only. So what happened? Then his mother gave him some money to buy the ice candy bar. But she made sure that, she told him that make sure the ice candy bar is wrapped properly, okay, or else if you eat an open ice candy bar, you will get sickness, you will get ill. Okay, so what happened? Rohit went to the ice candy bar. So he went to the ice candy bar. The shopkeeper asked, "Which candy bar?" As normally when you go to a shop, the shopkeeper asks, "What do you want?" So likewise, the shopkeeper asked Rohit, which candy do you want? Do you want a strawberry or do you want orange?" So Rohit thought for some time and he answered, "I want the orange bar." Okay, so now going on to the question answers. Choose the correct option to complete each sentence. First one, Rohit had promised his mother. What he had promised his mother? He would get an ice candy if he finished his homework, or he would finish his homework on time. So what was the correct answer? He would finish his homework on time. So you have to tick the B option, right? Exercise A, page 38. First one is A. You have to tick A option. Then second one, Rohit chose, what did he choose? Which candy did he choose? Only an orange candy or an orange or a strawberry candy? Only an orange candy. So second one is also A, right? Answer the questions using articles correctly. What advice did mother give Rohit? So what did mother give advice to Rohit? What did she say? To buy an ice candy bar which is covered properly, right? So here I'll write the answer. Exercise B. Answer 1. Mother advised Rohit to buy only that ice candy, which is wrapped properly. Okay. And the second question: how did Rohit go to candy camp? So how did he go to the candy camp? He cycled to the store. So he went on his bicycle. He cycled to the candy camp. Okay, the name of the shop was Candy Camp. Note it down, children. So children, the next exercise on page number 39, exercise A, add fire and rain to the words given in the box to make compound words. Then use these words to make sentences of your own. One has been done for you. So here, they have given some words in the box. So we have to add fire or rain to these words to make the correct compound nouns. Okay, we had learned about compound nouns. What are compound nouns? By adding two words, a new word forms. That word is a compound noun. Yes, by adding two nouns, we make a new noun. That is called a compound noun. So like bedroom, playground, homework, postman. So like this. So here they have given work, bow, fighter, place, drop, fly, fall, water. So to these words, whichever word suits, either fire or rain, a word aina edaithe set avutundi aa word manam dantoti kalpi, like work, so work tho tem a word set avutundi chudandi ok sari, fire or rain chudnama, fire work, first one is firework. On New Year's Eve, the fireworks lit up the sky. So, manam compound noun form chesi danni man sentence lo use cheskovali. We have to form the compound word and we have to use that word in our sentences. Okay. So, the second word is bow. Okay. So, what is the word? Rainbow. What is the word? Rainbow. By adding rain to bow, we made rainbow. So, sentence. What is the sentence? There appeared a rainbow appeared in the sky after it rained heavily. A rainbow appeared in the sky after it rained heavily. దీనికి అర్థం ఏంటమ్మా? ఇంద్రధనుసు, రెయిన్బో అంటే ఇంద్రధనుసు కదా. సో రెయిన్బో అపియర్డ్ ఇన్ ద స్కై ఆఫ్టర్ ఇట్ రెయిన్ హెవీలీ అంటే ఒక ఇంద్రధనుషును స్కైలో ఆకాశంలో కనిపించింది. ఎప్పుడు? గట్టిగా వర్షం కురిసిన తర్వాత. ఓకే, దెన్ థర్డ్ వర్ ఇస్ ఫైటర్. సో ఫైర్ ఫైటర్, వి యాడ్ ద వర్డ్ ఫైర్ టు ఫైటర్ అండ్ ద వర్డ్ ఇస్ ఫైర్ ఫైటర్. ఫైర్ ఫైటర్ is very brave. A firefighter is very brave. Fourth one, place. So again we add fire to place. So the word becomes fireplace. The word becomes fireplace. We all sat near the fireplace. We all sat near the fireplace. Fifth word, place. So, place you already wrote. Fifth one is draw. So, draw. We add rain to draw. So, it becomes raindrop. So, raindrop fell on my cheeks. Raindrop fell on my cheeks. Sixth one is fly. Firefly. We add fire to the word fire. So, there were many fireflies in the sky. Seventh one is fall. So, rainfall. Rainfall. We added rain to the word fall. Here, the rainfall is too heavy. Here the rainfall is too heavy. And the last one, eighth one is water. So we add fall to the word water. The word becomes waterfall. What does the become? Waterfall. That waterfall is very high. Okay? Rainbow. We added rain to the word bow. So it became rainbow. And the sentence is, a rainbow appeared in the sky after it rained heavily. Third one is fighter. So we added fire with fighter. The word became firefighter. The sentence is, a firefighter is very brave. Fourth one, place. So fire is added to the word place. So it becomes fireplace. We all sat near the fireplace. Fifth one, drop. We added rain to the word drop. It became raindrop. Raindrops fell on my cheeks. Then firefly. There are many fireflies in the sky. Rainfall. Here the rainfall is too heavy. Waterfall. That waterfall is very high. Note it down. So, exercise B on the same page, choose the correct antonyms for the words in color. Right? So, what are antonyms? Antonyms means opposite. Synonyms ante telusu kada, synonyms ante same meaning, antonyms ante opposites. Right? So, here, ikkada color words icharu, green color lo words icharu ki manamu opposites correct option choose cheyali. Ikkada 3 options icharu prati word ki. 3 options ichar. They have given 3 options for each word. So, we have to choose the correct antonym for this word. Okay, correct opposite man choose here. So, bright opposite antama, beaming ga, dull shining ga. Bright ante shining. So, beaming ante baga, car light ela untundi dan beaming anta. Okay, so bright opposite enti dull. Chudandi nenu rasanu dull. Bright, dull. So, మీరు ఏం చేస్తారంటే dull అన్న వర్డ్ ని అండర్లైన్ చేయండి. రైట్. సెకండ్ వన్ muddy. Muddy కి ఆపోజిట్ ఏంటి? clear, cloudy or dirty. Dirty meaning ఏంటి muddy. Cloudy అంటే cloudy మబ్బులు ఉంటాయి కదా ఆకాశంలో దాన్ని cloudy అంటారు. Muddy కి opposite ఏంటి clear. Clear. Third one smooth. Smooth కి opposite ఏంటి cozy ఆ rough ఆ glassy ఆ rough. Okay. So the words which I have written here, you have to underline it. Just underline it. You don't have to write it. Okay. Then fourth one calm. Calm అంటే ఏంటి calm అంటే ప్రశాంతంగా ఉంటుంది. So still, still అంటే కూడా ప్రశాంతమే. Loud అంటే గట్టిగా బిగ్గరగా. Peaceful కూడా peaceful అంటే కూడా ప్రశాంతమే. So the opposite of calm is loud. Then fifth one enjoyment. Enjoyment అంటే బాగా ఎంజాయ్ చేయటము అది. So enjoyment కి ఆపోజిట్ ఏంటి ప్లెజర్. ప్లెజర్ అంటే కూడా ఎంజాయ్మెంట్. డిలైట్ అంటే కూడా ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ లాంటిదే. మిజరీ అంటే ఏమీ లేకపోవటము బాధపడటం. సో ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ కి ఆపోజిట్ ఏంటి మిజరీ. నోట్ ఇట్ డౌన్. So the last exercise in this lesson, exercise C, match the words with their antonyms. One has been done for you. So here again we have to match the antonyms for the given words. Okay. So here are the words and these are the antonyms of these words. So we have to match them with the correct words. So first one is accept. Accept ante teeskuntamu. Accept ante teeskuntamu. So accept ki opposite ante refuse. Vaddu antamu. Okay. So here I'll write number one. Then second one busy. Busy ga untamu. Idle. Kali ga untamu. Okay. Third one courteous. Courteous ante manaki evaraina edaina pani chesi ichinappudu manamu valiki courteous ga undi thanks cheptam. So then opposite enti then opposite endama courteous ki opposite enti frown. Grumble చేస్తాం కదా frown అంటే grumble అని అంటాని జోగొనుకుంటాం దాన్ని అంటారు frown. ఓకే యాక్చువల్లీ రూడ్. ఫాస్ట్ స్లో. ఫాస్ట్ స్లో. హేట్ లవ్. హేట్ లవ్. Lie, truth. Lie, truth. Remember, forget. Remember, forget. Smile, frown. Smile, frown. Sorrow, happiness. And the last one, stale. Stale ante paachipoyindi. Fresh ante fresh ga unnadu. Okay. Again, once again, accept, refuse, busy, idle, courteous, rude. Rude ante krutagnyata lenollu ante neeku help chesna naaku help chesavanti pedda pani enti ee chesinanduku annantam kada adi. Fast, slow, hate, love, lie, truth. Lie ante abaddham, truth ante nijam. Remember, forget. Remember ante gurtu pettukuntamu. Forget ante marchipovadam. Smile, frown. Smile ante smile cheyadu. Frown ante ila pettukuntamu kopamga. Sorrow. Sorrow, happiness. Sorrow ante dukkham. Happiness ante santosham. Stale ante paachipoyindi. Fresh ante appude fresh ga undi. Okay? Perfectam. Right, children, so here we have completed this lesson, lesson number 5 regarding articles. So, after learning this lesson, after explaining this lesson, I hope you have understood it properly. Go through the exercises and complete each and every exercises neatly in good handwriting. Post the pics compulsory. Okay? Why we are telling again and again? You have to understand that it is for your good only. If you don't complete your books, you can't read them when you have your exams. Okay, children? Take care.